when the train arrives at its destination, the way people rushed it is not just nice at all.
Today I broke my phone actually. I had to like just even fix it.
Okay, no,
I broke my phone screen because I was trying to get into the train today. This is my third time taking the train, but it has been wonderful at least.
Get into the train. They are just simple signs, no eating, no drinking. You still see some people that will eat and drink and drop the bottle on the floor.
Je suis béninoise, c'est mon première fois.
The train is very impressive. I think you did a great job doing it. I'm very impressed also by the number of people that the train is carrying.
All right, so today we are actually riding the new train that was launched in Lagos, Nigeria, the Blue Line train. So today I'll be sharing with you guys how you can actually ride this train and everything in between. I'll also be interviewing a couple of people who have ride this train to also share their own experiences and how this train services can be improved, including asking those that also run the operations of this whole train service. So it's going to be a full video, all right? And if you watch this video and you like this video, please don't forget to give it a like and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. All right, let's get into the video. A few weeks back, the Lagos State government launched the first phase of the intercity rail system called the Blue Rail Line, expected to commute 250,000 daily passengers and ease the notorious traffic jam Lagos is known for. So once you come to the train station, your first step actually is to get a carry card. Without the carry card, you will not be able to board the train. So this is the card they are actually using for boarding of the train. And this card actually costs 500 naira. Then you can now load any amount you want to load in the card. I think the maximum is 10,000 naira. And then you can use this card, this same card, to ride for the train ride as well as the BRT buses and as well as the boats. So this card can serve for all of that. However, if you don't want to get a card, you can actually use the app to actually, you know, use your app, load it up, and then be able to use your phone, you know, to scan with the scanner and then, you know, proceed wherever you want. So this is actually the first step.
Lagos is essentially divided into two parts by water, the mainland and the island. The train connects the two locations by moving commuters in and from both ends. It currently runs from Marina in the island across five stops and terminates at Maitu on the mainland.
Once you come outside, actually, you can actually have a very beautiful view of this whole area, the marina. So here, you can see how beautiful this whole place is. So if you come much earlier, your train is not ready, you can actually take a look at all of these areas and all of that. So that's how this place is. So this is the entrance. And this side of the entrance is side that you just lift. By the other side, you actually use steps. If you don't want to get a good view of the ocean, you can get a good view of the city from here. Let me show you. So right there, you can see cars that are passing. All right, and you can have a very good view of the city itself just from here.
The infrastructure looks very nice and well put together, although a couple of work has still been done.
Doing a lot of construction going on in this place, so I think some stores are also going to open up in these places. Like I saw MedPlus and so many other people hanging their banner. So I think many stores are still going to open up much later. However, it would also be nice to have some kind of chair in this place so that people can actually sit down while waiting. As you can see, if you look around, all around here right now, you cannot find chairs for people to sit down. So people actually are just standing right now. And so if you have to wait for 1 hour, you probably will just have to stand. So one thing I also noticed is that once it's not the time for you to board the train, you cannot actually have access to the platform. The platform is what they call the name of the place where you actually have to go and board the train. So you can't have access to it until it's time for you to board. The next train will move around 5:30 and the boarding starts around 5. So right now, none of us are allowed to actually go across that point until it is time to board. So it's also part of a way to actually control the crowd and to make sure that everything is kept in check. So it's about time for us to board the train, and one thing you can see, there's a lot of crowd here and a lot of people are being impatient and a lot of talking and dragging is already about to start. So that's the thing. I think there's a lot of, there has to be a kind of a proper crowd control if we have to, you know, connect to have an efficient train system here. There's a lot of dragging and rushing that is actually going on, and I don't know why this is happening. Is it because people want to probably get the seats to sit down? That's what they are doing, that I'm not sure.
The crowd management, I think, is still something to worry about. You see people standing all around for like one and a half hours. There are no seats. What? As much as the train is a very good and efficient one, you've seen and in every train station all around the world, there are a little bit of issues of comfort that makes people a bit relaxed while waiting for train. And one way or the other, this is what makes people unnecessarily agitated. There is nowhere to stand, there is nothing to do, so many people want to quickly go.
Right now we are going to the platform one, and so this basically is the platform. So yeah, Marina. So now that we are up here at the platform, that they call it platform, which is where you actually have to board the train, but right now we still have to stand in another queue. So we are standing and we are waiting. So now the train has arrived and we are about to board, but there seems to be a whole lot of rushing. See the fight, see the rush. So what is happening is that someone actually dropped a plastic bottle on the train, which is not supposed to do, and is refusing to actually pick it up. So you can see how Nigerians can just try to mess things up by themselves. So the train is actually leaving right now, so let me show you the view that we are getting.
They are very tight. was supposed to have a proper crowd control, number one. And then they should have preference for people who came first. Because, like, my experience today, I was here, like, the train was supposed to leave by 5:30, and then I was here, like, 5 o'clock or 4:30. Yeah, I was here around 4:30, and I stood on the line. I couldn't go anywhere. I was standing, and after standing, I would still make it to the train and still stand for, like, 30 minutes. And whereas people who came quite later would have a seat to sit down because everybody's trying to push and get seat and everything. So I feel like we should do better.
So the crowd control has not been effective. So people still push and find their way.
Yes.
How long have you ride this train?
Okay, since it started, I've been riding it every day.
How many times now?
I think since from 2 weeks back, I've been riding like every day.
Every day?
Yes.
And it's been the same?
It's been the same. That's but like, there are times it's always fair. Like, the best time to enter the train is 5:30. Like 5:30, but there are some days the 5:30 is always worse. But 5:30 is the best time. So sometimes you get the train on time and then you can sit down. But sometimes you just have to stand. Like today, like I'm experiencing it. So.
Alright. So basically, what you are requesting is a proper crowd control. Let's probably kind of a numbering system. Who comes first should sit down.
So they should have like a numbering system for everybody. First come, first serve. If you're here on time, sit down. Those that came last, stand. If it works like that, same way they give preferences for people who are pregnant, people who have children, and the elderly. You should also give preference for people who came first. If you
are
cannot
giving preference for elderly in this train.
Yeah. They gave preference for elderly. Like today, I saw some elderly persons, some pregnant women, and people with babies sat first. Like they had to open the door for them first to enter before they had to open the door for everybody. So if they can give preference for those people, they should also give preference for people who came earlier, so they can have seat to sit down. Then every other person should stand. If it works like that, then we'll be okay. I think that should be better done.
My name is Godwin Monigo, a resident of Lagos. I stay in Ojo actually. So pertaining my experience on this rail, following this train, that's been wonderful so far. At least, although there are ups and downs, but let me start with the ups first. The train is timely, it's comfortable because there's AC inside. And I think it has been able to cushion the effect of traffic in the sense that it has packed a lot of persons trying to go to CMS in the morning and all that. So, but in the aspect, in the disadvantage or the other side, the downside of it is that, how will I say, a lot of persons, it has still not been able to pack the number of persons that are planning to go to CMS or my two in the evening. Then I think the crowd is too much, basically by 6:30. As you can see, 5:30 now, look at the crowd. But 6:30, it will be more than this and the rush. And one thing I don't like is the lack of organization.
Lack of
organization for those that came early, like me, I came early as 4, but I'm standing. Why some people that came around 5, they are seated? So it's not supposed to be like that. Everything is supposed to be in order as you came. So I think if they work on that, the train is efficient.
Now, earlier on, when we entered this train, there was a kind of a brawl because somebody dropped a plastic on the ground. And there's a sign that clearly says no eating, drinking or smoking. But yet the person drops. So if we still have signs like this and people still have to disobey, what else do you think we can do to improve and help Nigerians in education?
I just think they should make one or two people escape goats, and I think everybody will take dressing. Period.
That would be your advice.
Yes.